Tonight, despite the hopes created by President Trump's meeting with Kim Jong-un, there are now some troubling signs emerging that North Korea is making improvements to its nuclear facilities. CNN's Brian Todd has been checking with his sources. Tell us more about these recent changes, Brian.
Wolf, tonight we're told that one North Korean facility in particular, which has produced plutonium, a critical component in nuclear weapons, has undergone an upgrade. This despite all of Kim's promises at the summit and then President Trump's declaration that there's no longer a nuclear threat from North Korea.
Tonight, new evidence that Kim Jong-un could still be tweaking, making improvements to his nuclear facilities, despite his promise to President Trump to draw down his nuclear arsenal. New satellite images from the monitoring group 38 North suggest Kim's regime is making upgrades to its nuclear research facility at Yongbyon, upgrades which the group says are being done, quote, at a rapid pace.
And how's the meeting going so far, sir?
38 North believes much of that work took place before President Trump's summit with Kim on June 12th. But it says some of the work probably occurred after the Singapore meeting, after Kim's promise to work to denuclearize.
Now, if you were about to demolish your house, would you be upgrading the kitchen?
I think that that definitely calls into question whether or not Kim Jong-un came to this table in good faith.
38 North says it believes Yongbyon is no longer producing plutonium, crucial for nuclear weapons. But the latest photos show the Kim regime has made modifications to the cooling system for a reactor that has produced plutonium.
It is an important reactor. And you can draw the conclusion, of course, that if they intended to operate it in the future and it operated more efficiently, then it could more efficiently produce plutonium.
38 North also says its photos show Kim's regime has built two new small buildings at Yongbyon, which it believes could be intended for VIPs.
They could be outside inspectors intending to verify any new agreements, or they could be VIPs, whether it's visiting foreign press or North Korean leaders.
Neither the White House nor U.S. intelligence officials are commenting on these new images tonight. 38 North's Joel Witt says some of these upgrades could be so routine that they may not mean that Kim's going back on his pledge to denuclearize. Other analysts believe they know which way the dictator will go when he's pressured for specific cuts to his arsenal.
He has been very clear he wants to keep his nuclear weapons. He's declared that. It's in the North Korean Constitution. Nothing in the Singapore summit changes that.
Which leads tonight to a lingering question. Why did Kim come to the table in Singapore?
I think that they're hoping to so normalize and so sort of sanitize Kim Jong-un's image. I mean, we saw this selfies with the Singapore Prime Minister, walks along Marina Bay Sands in Singapore, handshakes with the president. He wants to sanitize his image so that he can then be included among other nuclear powers, like, for example, China or Russia.
Analysts say all of this now puts more pressure on President Trump, Mike Pompeo, and the rest of the Trump team tonight to exert their own pressure on Kim Jong-un to be more specific about the weapons that he's going to draw down and to get some of that in writing. Now, experts say Kim may very well balk at that. He may stall, he may deceive, but they say it's still important for Kim not to be seen as being the one who's dictating the terms of this agreement right now. Well, they've got to press him.
Brian Todd.